Ibrar Hussein Saab, viewers at home, brothers and sisters, elders and youngsters, each and every one of us, those who are taking part in this show, those who are watching at home, are blessed and fortunate that over the next hour and a half or so, we will hear in relation to an individual who was a man ahead of his time, a visionary, a pioneer, and as Hazrat Allama Sahib mentioned, an embodiment of Shariyat and Tariqat, none other than Shaykh al-Alam, Hazrat Khwaja Peer Alauddin Siddiqui Sahib, Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayhi. I want to applaud Ummah Channel, and in particular Barrister Ibrar Hussain Sahib, for having this foresight and taking the initiative, that's a way of putting it, taking the initiative of having this tribute show for Qibla Peer Sahib. I think whatever is said in relation to the legacy of Qibla Peer Sahib will never be able to fully do justice to his maqam o martaba.
Indeed.
He is an individual who is an embodiment of the verse that I had the sharaf of reciting from Surah Yunus. From what I know, I've had the honor of spending many gatherings in their time or with their sohbat, spending time with them. From what I see and what I saw, should I say, and from what I've heard from their murideen, from their rufaqa, no doubt Qibla Peer Sahib was an embodiment of this verse.
Subhanallah.
Ala inna awliya Allahi la khawfun alayhim wa la hum yahzanun. And often when we utilize this verse of the Quran in relation to the maqam wa martaba of the awliya ikram, some people feel that it's in terms of mubalagha, to do ta'rif, to honor and venerate that person, to make that person feel good. But no doubt Qibla Peer Sahib have done parda from this zahri dunya. There is no form of mubalagha here. There is no form of ta'rif in front of them in their mawjudgi or presence. Here, whatever we say comes from the heart and hopefully will enter into the hearts as well.
Inshallah.
And it be a tribute to the reality of their service and khidmat to Deen Islam. Because whatever they did was without any lalach, without any greed. There was no envy towards anyone. There was no such person is doing such a thing, I'm going to do something better than him. No. He led the way. Qibla Peer Sahib, rahmatullah alayhi, led the way in everything that he did. In the deen and in the dunya. 41 institutions they established in Pakistan and here in the United Kingdom as well. From what I've been told, 8 alone here in the UK, from them 41. In London, in Birmingham, in Manchester, in Oldham. An individual who left a legacy, and as you mentioned in your introduction, that we fear very few people will actually step into that void, will actually fill that void. So Qibla Peer Sahib led his life, la khawfun alayhim, without any fear, wa la hum yahzanun, and he didn't grieve anything. Tribulations came his way, hardships came his way. 11 years musalsal, learning about the Sharia, studying Deen Islam from amongst the great ulama ikram that they studied from. Hazrat Allama Sahib mentioned the great Muhaddis-e-Azam of Pakistan, Hazrat Allama Sardar Ahmad Qadri Sahib Rahmatullah Alayhi. Similarly, the great Mufti Abdul Ghaffar Hazabi Sahib Rahmatullah Alayhi, or the Tayajan of our Sheikh Tariqat Qibla Mufti Hassan Raza Sahib. For 5 years they studied with them, Hazrat Allama Qazi Ghulam Mahmood from Haripur, Rahmatullah Ta'ala Alayhi. So they studied with the great giants of their time, the great pioneers of their time, and them individuals molded the personality of Qibla Peer Sahib and molded the shakhsiyat of Qibla Peer Sahib, and not forgetting their honorable father as well, who was responsible. Qibla Peer Sahib spent 8 years in the khidmat of their walid.
8 years.
11 years studying the deen, 8 years doing khidmat of their walid sahib, and their walid sahib was doing tarbiyat of their son, And from their life, it's not just a case of mentioning their great achievements and going through their teachings and mentioning their life and ahwal-e zindagi. But we need to also take the lessons from their life and implement it into our lives as well. And allow ourselves to follow in their footsteps. So just to conclude on this opening statement, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala blessed them with many great qualities, many great aspects of their life, which alhamdulillah became apparent in front of each and every one of us. From amongst them is the verse of the Quran. He was an individual, la khawfun alayhim. From what I know, from what I've been told, Qibla Pisa did not have a single one of his institutes in his own name. No property in his name, no money, no jadat, nothing like this. He had nothing in his name. He left this dunya with, he came with nothing into the dunya, and he left this dunya with nothing, to the best of my knowledge. And he was an individual who grieved very little. He got on with his work, he served the deen, and he set an example for the rest of us to follow as well. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala allow us to follow in the next qadam. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala allow this show to be a success, so our viewers can fully and truly understand the great personality of Shaykh al-Alam, Peer Alauddin Siddiqui Sahib.